Hello, welcome to Local Edition. I'm Leslie Layton. Budget constraints are giving the state of education in California a real lesson in reality these days, many challenges facing education. With us now is James Ramos. He is a trustee with the San Bernardino Community College Board and also a member of the California Board of Education. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you for inviting me.
You know, what are some of the challenges facing education today?
Well, first off, you know, the budget constraints. But at the state board level, we're seeing a lot of waivers for classroom sizes to increase those sizes. So we're seeing a lot of that happening right now.
What effects do you see the budget constraints having on education and the economy?
I think it's parallel to the economy. I think with education, once you start to have an educated populace, you start to see the economy being able to rise. And what's happening right now, there's this restructuring going on within public instruction. We just had some laws that were put onto the board of the State Board of Education dealing with parent empowerment, where parents were able to go out and petition for low-performing schools to create a charter. So these are some of the constraints that you're seeing right now within these economic times, because everybody wants to make sure that their students and their children are getting a quality education in the state of California.
And your view is that working?
Well, we're all working together to make it reality. I think there's some challenges that face us all in every community, and certainly the state of California. So by working together, making sure that everybody's working together, going towards the same common goal, we'll be able to move forward.
Sometimes it seems that the solutions themselves create other problems. One of the ways to measure if a school is doing okay is testing. And then testing itself creates problems. Teachers complain that they're teaching to the tests.
Well, there is some constraints to that as far as testing and regulations and how far are we letting the students move forward on their own as far as making sure that somebody that can excel in math will excel in math, and someone that will excel in language and reading will excel. I think there's a one test fits all theory that might not be the right thing for education in our state.
Are you finding that high school graduates are prepared to enter college?
One of the big areas that myself, being an advocate on the State Board of Education, is for that EAP testing, making sure that when students do graduate from high school, that they're graduating ready to go into their freshman English and freshman math courses to move forward in higher education, regardless if you're going after your four-year degree, your associate's, or technical training, that you need to be able to be at that par, especially if you're graduating out of high school with a 4.0 or 3.0. Let's make sure that we do our part in partnering together to make sure that you can move forward in higher education. And one of those areas is actually EAP, early assessment testing on those areas, so that you're able to test in the 10th, 11th grade, get the feedback from those tests so that teachers then could put together some type of intervention model to make sure the students are getting the remedial courses that they need in order to move forward and reach that freshman English and freshman math. Moving on to higher education.
Yeah, education really does add up. If you come to a roadblock at any point in the education, it can often stop.
It does, and what you're really seeing at higher ed is a lot of remedial courses being needed. But if we could tackle these in the K through 12, then we're working together to solve that issue and to solve that problem and to really secure that dream for all the students that want to move forward in higher education.
What is your greatest focus right now that you think is the most important issue?
The most important issue is really working within the State Board of Education for the budget constraints and making sure that we still offer that quality education to the 6.5 million students in the state of California.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank
James
you.
James Ramos for being with us today. And thank you for tuning in. Stay with us, more HLN right after this.